So literally, her mahr was his Islam, was him accepting Islam. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Sulaim radiallahu anha was one of the greatest companions of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She in fact was one of his aunts from Medina, and we know her as Sulaim bint Milhan, the daughter of Milhan, and some of the scholars mention how her real name was Ar-Rumaysa. So she is residing in Medina. She was married to a man by the name of Malik ibn Nadr, and together they had a son by the name of Anas. Now when you put two and two together, you will realize that her son was none other than the great companion Anas ibn Malik radiallahu an. Now more on him later. Coming back to Sulaim, we said that she was married to Malik. Malik passes away, and she is left behind, you know, widowed with a young son. She is a single mother, and she's not really interested at this point in getting married again. But then comes along another man by the name of Abu Talha. And let's just say that Abu Talha ticks all the boxes. He's known for his looks. He's known for his bravery and his courage. He is well off. He is wealthy. And, you know, not many women in Medina would turn away a man like Abu Talha. So he actually proposes to Sulaim. And Sulaim really wasn't interested. And, you know, the most important thing to her as a Muslima, as a woman of faith, was indeed her faith. So she says to Abu Talha, who at this point was not a Muslim, who was not a man of faith, that I can't marry you and I'm not really interested in marrying you. However, should you decide to accept Islam and to embrace the faith, then I will agree to marry you. And in fact, on top of that, I will accept your Islam as my mahr, as my dowry. And if we just pause for a moment, by the way, we have to understand that this is Abu Talha. Okay, and Sulaim, as a widow, as a single mother, she could have asked for anything. She could have asked for wealth, for property, for land, you name it, he could have given it to her. But subhanAllah, she says and she states that she wants his Islam as her mahr, her dowry. Why? Because that's the most important thing to her. So, you know, Abu Talha, he goes to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he embraces the faith, he accepts Islam, and he ends up marrying Sulaim, and she, of course, you know, fulfills her promise. She accepts his Islam as her dowry, as her mahr, and subhanAllah, they have an amazing marriage together. They have children. One of the children, one of their sons, was known as Abu Umair, and that's Sulaim for you. And that just really, you know, epitomizes what kind of woman she was. And we said that, you know, her son was Anas ibn Malik radiallahu an. And something else quite amazing and remarkable that she did was when Anas was really young, we're talking around 10 years old, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he arrives in Medina after the hijrah, the migration, she actually offers her son Anas as a servant for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in service for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to help him out day to day. So Anas radiallahu an, he has this amazing mother, but now he has an amazing teacher and guide and someone to look up to on a day-to-day basis, and that is none other than our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he is there now, and he serves the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for the following 10 years. So he has this direct access into the home of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he's spending so much time with him. And Sulaim radiallahu anha is of course raising him as well. And Anas, as we know, you know, grew up to become one of the most iconic of companions, and someone who was extremely knowledgeable, and someone who our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua for and prayed for, that Allah blesses him in his wealth and in his offspring, etc., etc. So really, this is Sulaim radiallahu anha. This is her amazing story. And there's so much we can learn from her. And there is no doubt that she is one of the wonder women. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with her.